All right.
Hey, I'm Lips, and this is Lewis. Okay, we're going to do this interview.
Awesome, man.
I mean, I might as well do the entry.
Here you go. Take it.
Okay, what brings you here?
I'm here to see you.
He's here to see me. I'm Lips from the band Anvil.
And I'm excited to be here, man.
It's great to be here, man. This is my first time in this situation here at NAMM.
Yeah.
And it only figures
right.
that I'd end up being sponsored and have an endorsement from Bujera.
Yeah.
I've never had an endorsement.
So this is exciting.
Yeah, it's like I never had an endorsement before, and I've never been to NAMM. It all came at once.
So, I mean, in your landscape, we're growing. You're growing. You're getting bigger. You have endorsements. You're at NAMM. There are people online to get autographs and watch your concert. He's putting on a concert right at NAMM, right in the middle of the hall.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I know. Unbelievable.
That's
man.
Awesome.
Like, not only did I come to NAMM, I get to play here.
You get to play
like,
here.
What?
In the middle of the show, the biggest booth on the showroom floor.
Hey, man, I've been the world's guinea pig for lots of stuff.
Right. Well, you're the leader here, man. You're in the biggest booth on the showroom floor.
It's very,
you're the only
very
one
cool.
with the concert stage. That's awesome.
That's great,
and congratulations.
Man. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that.
Tell me about Bugera. So how long have you been with them, and what do you like about them?
Well, we just got acquainted recently.
I could hold that for you if you'd like, though.
That's okay. We just got recently acquainted.
Yeah.
I'd never even heard of the company. Mm-hmm. And a number of months ago, I'd gone out and spent a whole fortune on new amplifiers.
Right, right.
I won't mention the company.
Sure.
Because what they did is they changed their policy and no longer gave artists prices. And I had to pay full price for my equipment.
Right.
After I went out and bought four of these heads for nothing less than $1,500 a piece.
Right.
I find out that there's a company that wants to help me out.
Right.
So I was kind of hesitant. I'm going like, I don't know if it's going to be as good, if it's going to sound as good, but I'm really particular, and I know a little bit about electronics in the sense that I use tubed amplifiers, and particularly tubed amplifiers that have 6L6s in them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This company sent me a link to look at their stuff, and I start looking through all their equipment, and they make these beautiful combos called a 6260. And like, I love combo amps.
That's always played combos.
I've always used combos because they're what's really good about combos is they're omnidirectional.
Right.
Because the backs, they're open back cabinets, the sound tends to go everywhere.
You know, I always say that to people. I'm a fan of open back cabinets because it always sounds bigger.
Well, it's everywhere. The sound goes everywhere.
That's right.
And I like to use the combination of a closed cabinet with the combo.
Right.
But what's really good with a combo is the drummer can always hear you monitored or not.
Right.
That's, and Rob and I are...
So you take the 4x12, you throw the combo on top of that, and it's...
You can hear it.
Everywhere.
We don't have to monitor or nothing.
Right, right.
There's that, and it's... The other thing that's really great about combos, in some clubs that we play, there's not enough room.
Yeah.
So all I do is I bring my combo in.
Right.
It's like a little amp, but
it's the same sound, so you're not switching.
It's the same sound.
Same sound, right, right,
yeah.
Right. That's good stuff, man. And which model Bugera do you play?
I ended up using, I tried their 333, which is very nice, no problem, but I like, why am I got a three-channel amp when I'm only using one?
Right, right, right.
I'm only using one, and I don't use the distortion on board.
Got it, got it.
So
what distortion do you use?
I'm using a pedal from the 1980s called the Tokai.
Oh, okay, the Tokai, right.
Which was equivalent to the Boss DS1 of that era.
And you also play the same guitar from way back when, right?
Yeah.
Which guitar?
I have custom-made guitars that are semi-hollow.
Yeah.
It's a semi-hollow Flying V.
Yeah.
Thing is, I love semi-hollows.
Yeah.
But me using like an ES-335 or something like that, it looks like Nugent.
Right.
I needed...
And you're about metal.
Well, it's not even a question about metal or not, or... I needed something that was my own.
Gotcha.
That's my own signature,
there
my own
go.
Thing.
Okay.
And I'm all about that. It's not about I want to play what the other guy plays. I want to play something that's completely mine.
Sure, sure.
And what I did is I came up with this idea, why can't I make a hollow V?
Right, right.
Which will sound like the 335.
And kind of like the open back, big open sound of an open back, you also get that with the semi-hollow.
Well, the combination, basically the combination of an ES-335 through a Fender Twin is the almighty sound to me. Because there's only the solid body Gibson sound and the hollow body Gibson sound.
Right, right, right.
And then there's the Stratocaster.
Sure.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's all there is.
Right, right.
You know, yeah, you can put different pickups in the guitar and so forth, but generally speaking, those are the three animals.
Right.
There's three breeds.
Yep.
The Strat is unto itself.
Yep.
Single coil, the way that sounds.
Sure.
But I really like the semi-hollow because of harmonic feedback.
Sure.
Not squealing.
Yep.
It's harmonic feedback. The resonation, the body resonates from the sound, from the acoustic sound around it.
Right.
That vibrates the strings and you get endless sustain on any note on the neck.
Right.
And that's what's different. Mm-hmm. When you use a solid body, it's not the same. And the more solid and the heavier the guitar, the harder it is for that string to vibrate from the sound coming out of your amp.
Right.
It's actually the other way around.
Sure.
A lot of guitarists think the more solid, like I'm going to get a Les Paul that weighs a ton and it's going to have major sustain. Wrong.
Right.
You'd be better off with a 335 and standing 5 feet off your amp. You can get it. You can get sustain on any note, like a Stratocaster.
Right.
The Stratocaster and a semi-hollow have a lot of the same harmonic feedback properties. I mean, that's why did Hendrix use a Strat?
Right.
It's because he can go woo 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 in front of the amp.
Right.
It makes the strings vibrate.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
it's
mm-hmm.
It's harmonic feedback. It's not the pickups feeding back. It's the string being vibrated by the sound out of the amp.
Right.
That's what we're talking about. And the more resonation within the body that vibrates the bridge, which vibrates the string.
Right.
So sustain on every note.
Gotcha. Before they pull you away from me, because you're going to be going live soon.
Right.
One last question for you. You had a new album come out a couple of years ago.
Right.
Is there a new album coming out?
Oh yeah. We just completed our 15th album.
I know, that's amazing.
So, and it's going to be called Hope and Hell.
Okay.
And it'll be out towards the end of May.
Okay. I can't wait to hear it.
Oh, it's. You know what's really interesting? Anvil is one of those weird, anomalous things. We're writing, and we're the best we've ever been.
Yep.
And it's not like I'm 25.
It's okay, man. It's about passion. It's not about your age. It's about
and
the passion.
I gotta tell you, man, that I've never lost that passion.
Right.
And never will.
I watched your movie, Anvil, The Story of Anvil, and if someone said, tell me what that movie was about, it was about passion. That's what it was about.
Passion. Perseverance, and doing something because you love it.
Absolutely.
It's not about money, never has been.
Right.
If it had been about money, I would have quit.
Right,
who
exactly.
Who wouldn't? I mean, there's thousands of people here who never make money from the music business.
Right.
Musicians.
And 90, here you are on that swing.
I said it in the movie and I'll say it again. 99.9% of musicians never get paid.
Yeah. Well, keep doing what you're doing because it rocks. There's a whole new generation out there that is just kind of putting their headphones on or their iPod on for the first time. They'll have an opportunity to hear your music. And the fact that you're still rocking out today, man, you're not only giving them an opportunity to listen to your music, but to actually come see you live. So keep
doing it. And live it.
And live it. So keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you very much.
Because it rocks, man.
It.
Congratulations with Bugera. It's a great name, great amp. I have a great relationship with these guys, so I'm happy to have an opportunity to interview you.
Okay, thank you.
Have a great show.
Okay, I will.
And keep rocking.
You know it.